Good day guys, and welcome back to another LumaFusion 3.1 video. In today's video, we're gonna do a quick dive into the histogram, how it works and how we can easily read it. So without further ado, let's jump over to the iPad. So moving over to LumaFusion and over to the color and effect section where we can find our video scopes. The one that we have here now is the histogram, and it's extremely easy to read. So the left side of the histogram represents the shadows, the middle of the histogram represents the midtones, and the right side represents the highlights. A good exposure usually looks like a single or multiple mountains in the middle, where a bad exposure usually looks like a cliff or a spike at the left or the right side. And when adjusting the exposure of your image, there's two sides you want to keep an eye at: the left, which is the shadows, and the right, which is the highlights. When correcting your footage, you want to make sure you're not pushing the highlights and shadows beyond the edge of the histogram. If your footage looks like this, that means you have clipping in your image, either in the highlights or shadows. When having these spikes at the left or right side, it usually means that your video is way over or underexposed, and you lost the information in the highlights and shadows, also called clipping. Now let's say you recorded a video with your camera and you experienced some unwanted clipping in camera. You should also be able to see this within LumaFusion as a static spike on the left or right side, depending on the image being underexposed or overexposed. This depends on the type of footage you've captured, and is what you might experience in a lot of your footage which also contains the sky. An example is when you expose for your scene, it's usually exposed according to the background, foreground, a subject, or an object you want to film. If you happen to do your exposure in a darker area, you might also grab a piece of the sky as well, depending on where you shoot, of course. But then you will also most likely have an overexposed sky. It's also good to know that you can actually separate the different channels of the histogram, and you can also have each separate channel available at once. And by separating the channels, you're allowed to see each of the three RGB panels. That gives you a more accurate view over the different tones. You can also change the values of the different sections by adjusting the RGB sliders in the Settings tab. This offers more control and makes it easier to see and place the selected colors. Now, in the next video, we'll take a look at the waveform, how it works and how we can easily understand it in a simple way. I hope you found some value in this quick explanation. Check out the latest deals in my online shop where you can find tons of LUTs and presets for LumaFusion. Check out my latest updated color grading tutorial as well if you want to learn more about color grading different styles in LumaFusion. That's going to be everything for today's video. Thanks for tuning in, and I will catch you in the next video.